Hi, this is David Cadavy with Cadavy.net, and today I'm going to show you how to transfer your iTunes library from one computer to another without losing your song ratings or your play counts. These can be very valuable when it comes to actually navigating your music on your computer. There's a number of ways to actually get the physical files to a new computer, but retaining play counts and song ratings requires a little bit of hacking. So first, we're on our old computer. We're going to go to our iTunes menu, File, Library, Export Library. This is going to create an XML file. I'm just going to export this to my desktop, and it's going to have all this information in there about my play counts and my song ratings. Now you're going to want to actually transfer the actual files over to the new computer. There's a number of different ways to do this. Probably the best way is with an external hard drive. I'm not personally going to go through all the details of that right now, but to find out where your music is in your old computer, just go to your iTunes library, right-click on a song, go Show in Finder, or if you're on a Windows machine, it will say something else, obviously, and you'll see where one of your files are. Go back through the directory structure a little bit, and then you'll see the root folder that holds all of your iTunes media. So this folder right here that says iTunes Media is a folder that I would want to transfer to my new computer. And I'll meet you over there in a second. Okay, here I am. I'm over on my new computer. It looks oddly similar, doesn't it? Anyway, I've got an empty iTunes library. I've got my XML file, library.xml, over here. And I've got my iTunes media file here on my desktop. First thing I want to do is go into iTunes, Preferences, Advanced. Make sure this Copy Files to iTunes Media folder when adding to library is selected. And it is. That is good. Now, this iTunes Media folder has a space in the name of it. That's just going to complicate things. So let's just change the name to just iTunes Music with no space. Now we're going to open up the library.xml file. And look in here. You're going to see this says Music Folder. String file. Now this is the file path of where the music folder was on my old computer. Now if you're doing this, you're probably doing it from a Windows to a Mac. It probably says C:\. So watch out for those backslashes when we change this file path. So what we're going to do is find the file path of our new music folder. I'm going to right click, say get info. You can see it's at users, guest, desktop, and then of course it's iTunes Music. So what we're going to do is do a find change. And if you're going to a Mac, make sure you remember this file :\. We're going to do a find change. We're going to find everything that says this. We're going to copy it. Go to file, or excuse me, edit, find. And paste that in there with Command-V, Open Apple V. Replace with, now we're going to type in our new file path, file:\. Users with capitalized, guest capitalized, which you probably have a different username. And then desktop capitalized, and another :\, iTunes Music, and then one final :\. Now we're going to do replace all. And that is going to change automatically everything in our whole library.xml file that says that. Now we're going to save that library.xml file. All right, so now I'm going to actually import this library using this XML file. So I'll go to File, Library, Import Playlist, find my library.xml file, and wait a little bit, and it will automatically import my library. Now, while I'm waiting for that, I'll tell you that you can also find written instructions on this at cadavy.net on my post, Transfer Your iTunes Library from One Computer to Another. If you wanted to find this, you could just search for Transfer iTunes Cadavy. Also, I have the link in the sidebar. It's finally done transferring. And you can see now I have all my song ratings on here, and I started with a dummy library, so I would have play counts on there. If you're wondering why I have so many ones and twos in my libraries, it's because I organize it using a mood-based iTunes rating system. You can also find that on Katavi.net by searching for mood-based Katavi, or I have the link in the sidebar for that. So anyway, I hope this helps you transfer your iTunes library from one computer to another. You get to save all your song ratings, your play counts, and even your playlists as well. This has been David Katavi with Katavi.net.